processing towards a very great NH road, having a very similar and homogeneity observation and practice. The thing in which we have been dwelling and practicing for the past 10 or 12 or 15 years, even we are struggling in that. You are going to teach something which we have never heard of, which is anonymous and cryptanonymous. You are going to teach something new. It is an alienistic science. So how we are going to master it? If we are going to master it, would it be a cognitive load on us? Certainly it will not be so. Because real education will make you to go for additional resources. What is additional resources? Number one, that's what I have seen in few people. In my younger ages, I have seen in few people. Whenever you see, if you are given some school textbooks, you are given one or two school textbooks. I have seen two or three people among thousands who are not satisfied with the textbooks. They will go for library, get some books and get additional information. They will ask more questions and widen the knowledge. So additional resources, whenever you get a book, the book should give you dissatisfaction. You have to go for additional resources. That is the real methodology of study. Even if the book is a burden for you, that will be the time for a person to see it or to realize about additional resources. So cognotechnology is a technology by which you are taught how to handle and organize the stuff in a simpler and sweeter manner. For example, if you don't know about something, certainly you will get that fear. For example, I am simplifying you something. I am bringing your caliber to the level of the stuff level of the syllabus. Then it becomes simple. Whenever something becomes simple, that becomes structured. Whenever something becomes, if it is well taught, if it is psychoanalytically taught, understanding the caliber level, intention level and receptorial level of the student, if it is taught methodologically, that becomes simple. That which is taught simple, that becomes structural. You know X, then Y, Z, you know the order, sequential synthesis is made. If something becomes simple and structural, naturally that becomes speed. Something that is simple, structural and speed, that becomes encapsulated inside your mind. I want to say one something, encapsulation or sangrahana is a very great skill of human mind according to Shastras. It is known as essential absorption. I want to clear something. If there is 1500 words in a stuff, it is enough if you understand 20 or 25 key words inside that. Your essential absorption memory understands only the key points. Whereas the microneural epistomes, what are the epistomes? Epistomes are like protons and neutrons. Epistomes are the knowledge particles. So these micronutrient epistomes inside your brain are cognitive ether that will re-summarize, elucidate, expand and restructuralize the things that are hidden inside you. Don't think that you have to understand everything. If you are having a book of 200 pages, that 200 pages can be encapsulated or the essential absorption can be made within 10 or 15 pages. If you remember the 10 or 15 pages by means of your cognitive programming, suddenly at that time the micronutrient epistomes of your cognitive ether, they will try to expand and present it in a fully structured, reorganized manner with fullest precision. That is possible by that. So you are not understanding that type of system, you are not having that cognitive taming of your mind or brain or intellect, due to which you suffer with this service. So this gives you the clear idea that cognitive training or cognitive technology is not an additional burden for your already existing syllabus, but it converts the already existing so-called burden in the disguise of a boon that you are expecting for a job or realization or scientific success. It is going to convert that burden into a blessing, a rejoicing. The same cognitive technology, if it is applied to your 5 years of study, with lesser risk of studying, more impact of deeper or prolonged memory, more precision in your performances can be guaranteed by this cognitive technology. What are cognitive technologies? I have already told about cognitive technology in the previous lecture. Applying technology or technology driven software, for example, there is an acharya, there is a teacher. In his physical, human, biological form, by means of his mutual sharing, in the form of instruction, methodology and approach, the person is teaching you with his three things. One is his inspiration. Inspiration is possible only by a person's presence, a person's radiation, a person's erudition, a person's compassion, and a person's interactive skills and mutual affinity. Can a software represent all of these things and replace them? Whatever your teacher is going to teach, that can be replaced by a computer or a software. But what about the magnanimous shape and structure? Whether the teachers are having these things or not, I don't know. But for an ideal teacher, but for an ideal instruction methodology and learning methodology, the teacher should have a pleasing experience. displeasing experience will make the person to attend the classes in spite of his physical unwillingness or physical unwell conditions. In spite of being ill, in spite of being unwell mentally also, the person should be driven to go to the classroom. So, a person's appearance, experience and mutual affinity, this cannot be replaced by a computer or a software. I have already told about Cognifit. The previous lecture I told about Cognifit. It deals with phobic erosion. How to erode phobia in chemistry, physics, mathematics, etc. How to simplify and understand mathematical problems, logical solutions and algorithms. How to construct that. It will also guide with you. How to master languages. So there are various other things which are given for various demonstrative and learning exercises. Now I am going to tell you about that cognitive technology. Technology, what is technology? Applying a tool for getting something is known as technicality. Technos is known as a designed tool, and engineering is a process of designing a tool. So a tool which is meant for everything is a technology only. Even if your lever, even if you make a small rod to hold a stone and pull something, even that is a tool. So tool is of mechanical tool, there is a manual or innate tool, it may be automation tool, it may be a sensor tool, it may be an artificial intelligence tool. Five sections of tools are there: innate tool, mechanical, automotive, sensorial, and now we are having artificial intelligence and advanced simulative models now. So whatever it may be, it is a tool. I am going to teach about that cognitive technology in which you use yourself as a tool. Just as a person getting jute will get jute from the forest, bind the jute with the same jute. Like that, mind is not only the tool to understand everything, it is a tool to manifest, manipulate and man its own self. So understanding the second dimension of mind, first dimension of mind in cognitive technology is understanding mind as a tool for other technologies. That is, mind can have five dimensions. One is inert, second is invert, third thing is inhibitive, fourth thing is innate, fifth thing is inventive. These are all the dimensions of mind. What is it? Inventive. I can invent a bike or an automobile which can run with 100 kilometers per hour. That is my inventive mind. This mind only, this body cannot run with the speed, but this mind has invented an automobile which can run with the speed. This is known as inventive caliber of the mind. Number two, inhibitive caliber of mind. I don't know to invent all of these things, but if something is there, I can identify it and use it. That is known as inhibitive. I don't know anything, I want to sit quietly and enjoy my life. That is inert. And other thing is innate. The same thing, you have to understand this, I want to repeat it twice. Everything that you have designed by your mind, any device, irrespective of the function or functional precision or status, can be administered by the same mind itself without the aid of the device. That is known as innate. Follow that. Whatever the mind devises, the devising mind can be a good replacement for the device itself, provided the mind is so deep, strong built, well organized. If the mind can invent a television, the mind may also have the function of the television. That cognitive technology I am going to state, and also in that I have given three things. One is spiritual, second is sophisticated, third thing is simple or preliminary. I don't know how many of people you are going to come to spiritual, I don't request or compel them also. Sophisticated, one or two people they can come, but for simple and preliminary exercises, for making education rejoiceable, to widen more in their applications and scientific temper, to have more deeper thinking, to have a more broader vision in bringing real harmony and productivity to the society, the simpler exercise of cognitive technology can be used. So what is the innate dimension of mind? Whatever the mind devices, the same